Hi, everyone. I'm Greg, and I lead the Health AI research team at Google. I've been working on expanding the capabilities of AI at Google for a long time, but for the last few years, I've been focused on applying AI to healthcare, because I believe that health and medicine offer some of the greatest opportunities for this technology to deliver real, positive change in the world. You've already heard about how our breakthroughs in generative AI like MetaLLM are being improved and explored in real-world care settings, but now I'm excited to share some of our forward-looking research aimed at bringing us to the next frontier of healthcare innovation. We truly are in a new era of AI innovation. At Google, the Gemini family of models is unlocking new capabilities to power this era. We've fine-tuned Gemini models for the medical domain and have been evaluating their performance across a wide range of tasks. I'd like to talk specifically about how we've seen gains in advanced reasoning, in long context windows, and in multimodality. Let's start with advanced reasoning. About a year and a half ago, we built the first AI system that was able to achieve a passing score on a medical licensing exam benchmark called MedQA. Our newest model, fine-tuned for the medical domain, achieved state-of-the-art performance on the medical QA benchmark, standing at over 91%. Now, medical exam questions may be where we started this journey, but they're hardly an end in and of themselves. You see, in medicine, context matters. And that's why we've expanded our evaluations to investigate long context window tasks, asking models to sift through large quantities of information, like text, images, audio, or video, to extract relevant information. This is particularly important in the healthcare industry, which generates over 30% of the world's new data annually. When doctors see new patients, particularly in complicated cases, they have questions about the patient's medical history. Much of this information is held in dense electronic medical records. But now we've observed that if we provide a synthetic medical record as part of the context, our models are able to correctly and directly answer a physician's questions about the patient's history. Video is another important means of knowledge sharing, but unlocking meaningful insights from medical videos has been challenging. We've tested our new model's ability to answer questions based on content from educational medical videos posted on YouTube. On a data set of examples of this kind of task called MedVidQA, our model sets a new bar for state-of-the-art performance. Video is both an example of a long context window capability, and also a multimodal capability, which is what I want to talk about next. Multimodality is the ability to absorb and reason across multiple different data types, like text, images, and audio. Gemini models were built from the ground up to be multimodal. And after all, medicine is also inherently multimodal. To make the best care decisions, healthcare professionals regularly interpret signals across a plethora of sources, including medical images, clinical notes, electronic health records, and lab tests. To be genuinely helpful, AI should be able to follow a care team's reasoning as it crosses the boundary between these different information types. For example, a radiologist interpreting a chest x-ray will need to create a report about the image, describe the findings, and answer questions from the referring physician. The physician, in turn, will need to take actions based on that report. It would be a big help if AI could assist the radiologist by spotting errors or omissions, or even helping to draft the report itself. As a proof of principle, we built a model that can generate radiology reports based on a set of open access de-identified chest x-rays. We found that the majority of the reports generated by our model were considered to be comparable in quality to radiologist reports. But chest x-rays are a two-dimensional kind of imaging, flat pictures. But more complicated cases often required 3D imaging, like CT scans or MRIs, that can reveal findings that are invisible in a 2D image. We tested how our new model would perform on the significantly more complex task, report generation for 3D brain CTs. With these 3D images, we found that a significant portion of the reports that our model generated were judged by independent clinicians to be on a par or better than manually created reports. While these results are very encouraging, they're not an endorsement that these AI systems are ready to be trusted to generate radiology reports independently. Instead, they emphasize that it's time to evaluate AI's ability to assist radiologists in real-world report generation workflows. We plan to release a paper on our results in the coming months. But the real hallmark of the kind of multimodal intelligence that we need in medicine is flexibility. Beyond tasks like report generation or even genomic sequencing, our model showed state-of-the-art performance on medical visual question answering benchmarks and on complex diagnostic challenges. This demonstrates the model's flexibility across a wide range of tasks and modalities. But let's all remember one of the most important elements of medicine, the conversation between patients and their care teams, where skilled and intentional communication drives diagnosis, management, and trust. We've introduced Articulate Medical Intelligence Explorer earlier this year, or AMI for short. AMI is a research system that is based on an LLM. We've trained it to explore how AI can support clinical conversations by asking contextually relevant questions in search of a diagnosis. Empathy is a core part of medicine. So we've designed this model to communicate with respect, explaining things clearly, and supporting the individual in their decision-making process. This better reflects real-world clinical consultations, where caregivers always ask for the information that will give them more insight in the patient's care in the most humane way possible. We've performed two randomized studies to understand how this LLM would perform. In our first study, we tested the LLM's ability to generate a differential diagnosis alone or as an aid to a clinician. In this research, we evaluated our LLM using over 300 New England Journal of Medicine case challenges. These challenges present complex scenarios that a doctor might face in a clinical setting, including diagnostic dilemmas, unusual presentations of disease, or treatment decisions with difficult trade-offs. These challenge cases are a way for doctors and medical students and other healthcare professionals to sharpen their skills. In our study, we found that the LLMs have the potential to improve clinician performance when generating a differential diagnosis, even surpassing individual clinicians when it's operating alone. In our second study, we evaluated the LLM's conversational capabilities by having it interact with patient actors in a mock clinical examination. We found that the system was capable of dialogue and diagnostic reasoning and conversing with patient actors in a helpful and empathetic way. It's worth noting that these studies were all conducted in a simulated environment, and they aren't necessarily representative of everyday clinical practice. And while we think these early results with AMI are very promising, we need to understand whether a system like AMI can be of real use in a real clinical setting. And if it is useful, how should it interact with care teams to be as assistive as possible? Our next step will be to test this with a healthcare organization to understand how an LLM like AMI can be helpful in supporting clinical diagnostic conversations. We hope to learn how useful a model like this is, both for clinicians and for patients. And of course, with constant oversight of medical professionals. As a reminder, this research is about exploring the art of the possible in healthcare. And if it is possible, whether and how to build it safely, equitably, and in an assistive way.